To finish a Möbius cowl, you first need to block your cowl to the dimension specified in the pattern. You're going to need to just lay it flat to dry and then check the width and the height against the measurements in the pattern. You're also going to need to weave in any ends except the yarn you've left attached to your work to use for Kitchener stitch. This piece of yarn should be about 4 times the circumference of the end of the tube. Once you've blocked your cowl and it's completely dry, you'll need to transfer both ends to some needles. You can use the needles you use to knit your cowl and also a set of needles that's a similar size. It doesn't have to be exactly the same. I didn't have the exact same needles to use again, so I just used a slightly smaller pair of needles. At the end of your cowl are your provisional cast on edges. This is the end where you don't have your yarn still attached because that's where you just finished knitting. You're going to need to slip half your stitches. So I've counted half my stitches and added a stitch marker. So I'm just going to slip my stitches until I get to this marker. So I'm just going to slip purlwise until I get to the marker. So insert your needle as if to purl and slip that across. Again, insert your needle as if you're going to do a purl stitch and then just slip that across and just keep going until you get to your marker. So now I've nearly reached my marker. I can just remove that now. Now the reason we slipped those stitches is so we can add a twist to the cowl, because now both of our needles are pointing in different directions but we need them to be the same way. So if you just take one end and just flip it over, so now your needles are pointing in the same direction and we're ready to do some Kitchener stitch. So you're going to need to thread this yarn onto a tapestry needle so we can start grafting these together. If you didn't leave a piece of yarn attached to your work, you can just use a new piece of yarn. So we've got both ends of our cowl and we're going to use this side that's closest to us and the side that's furthest from us. So you can ignore these two middle parts and just bring these two outer needles together. And you can pull these needles in the middle out of the way so they don't get confusing, because we're just going to be working with these two needles. So the first thing we're going to do is add a stitch marker to the first stitch on the front needle and the first stitch on the back needle. This is just going to make it easier to spot these stitches when we get to the end and need to close up the hole. So I've got both of those stitch markers in place and I'm ready to start doing some Kitchener stitch. When doing Kitchener stitch in the round, you don't need to do any setup, you can just get started. So on the front needle, you're going to insert your needle as if to knit and take that off the needle, and then on the second stitch insert your needle as if to purl and bring it through. Now on the back needle, you're going to need to insert your needle as if to purl and bring the stitch off the needle, and then insert your needle as if to knit and leave that on the needle. So you're just going to repeat that until you reach the last two stitches. So on the front needle, insert as if to knit, take that off the needle, insert as if to purl, leave that on the needle and just thread that all the way through. Then on the back needle, insert as if to purl, take that off the needle, insert as if to knit, and leave that on the needle. So I'll just show that again. Going to the first stitch, you insert your needle as if to knit on the front needle, take that off, and then into the next stitch, insert your needle as if to purl, leave that on. Then on the back needle, insert your needle as if to purl, take that off, and then in the next stitch, insert your needle as if you're going to do a knit stitch, and bring that all the way through. As you're working along your cowl, just make sure you bring your yarn all the way through so this is nice and closed up, and then you can pull on your work a little bit just to make sure it's not too tight, just periodically as you work your way around the cowl. Now I'm just going up to the last few stitches, so once again, knit off, purl on, and then on the back needle, purl off, and knit on. So I'm just up to the final 4 stitches, so once again, knit off and then purl on. And then on the back needle, I'm going to purl off and knit on. Now we're going to make use of those stitch markers we added earlier. So because we just have these 2 stitches left, we're also going to use the stitches that are attached to these stitch markers to count as our other 2 stitches. So on the front needle, I'm going to knit off, and we need to purl on, so I'm just going to put this needle down out of the way, and then grab my stitch marker for the front stitch, which is this one. And I'll just go purlwise into that one. And then for this back stitch, you're going to go purlwise into that one, take the needle out. Can bring that all the way through. And then I'm going to go knitwise into this stitch attached to the back stitch marker. And just bring that all the way through, and then I can take those markers out. Now I'm just going to use some duplicate stitch to weave in this end. So my yarn's coming out of here. I'm just going to come up into this stitch here. Then I'm going to follow this stitch round at the top. So you can see the stitch above that. Just go through both legs of that. And then we're going to go back where we started into this stitch. And then I'm going to go along to another stitch and just do that again. So we're right next to this stitch here, so I'm going to go up in through the middle of this stitch. And then I'm going to go around the top. So just around there. And then back through the center of this stitch. And that's probably enough for this. So I'm just going to push that through to the inside of the cowl. And then I'm just going to leave the end inside the cowl and take my needle out. So you can see where I've taken the needle out, there's this little end here. So I'm just going to trim that quite close to the cowl. And then when I stretch that, that'll disappear inside the cowl. If I just pull on the cowl a bit. Now that's gone. But that's nice and secure now. So that's our Möbius cowl complete with the twist added in. You can also do this without adding the twist, you just don't slip half the stitches before you start doing kitchener stitch.